Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome tonight. We've got only one match going into this, but we have got a best of two, and it's going to be between Copenhagen Wolves and Arctic. And I'm here again with Volti. This is for the game on King of Kings, and we're going to be heading straight into the first map. What's up, Volti?
First of all, I just want to say that this spawn that comes sometimes as a bug in the beginning of rounds should not be there. It has seriously, in some games, had the glaive spot that he was spawned in. It has seriously had very huge impacts on rounds that I've seen before. Like, you're coming out just a second too late or something, out along. But this time it didn't, because he stayed in middle. But, so, small bug right there. But we're back. Arctic versus Copenhagen Wolves. And we will be seeing Arctic. Arctic, who has had major flaws, at least in the earlier games, at least in this tournament as well. I'm not sure in the other qualifiers and tournaments that they're playing. If they've got the same results, but in this particular tournament against particular teams, they haven't played their best game. So let's see if they can step it up tonight. Twista will be going in for the first kill, almost finishing off Percy, but Percy has that information now. They will be trading up and over. The B side is going to be crowded by four people. Arctic holding off their back, and this is a smart play because they can get. This is where they can just back off. They can just rotate to the A side as soon as they get that first kill, but no push is going to be applied by Copenhagen Wolves from middle, as they will be losing their first member, being Percy. Copenhagen Wolves still not sure what Arctic wants to do here, playing that very safe and neutral play that we talked about earlier. I think that was on Tuesday. We'll see if it works this time on Cobblestone. Sorij and the gang, not Sorij, sorry, coming up towards the A side. It looks like they want to execute. Hunden going very offensive here to clean up behind the B side, making sure that this is actually confirmed as an A push. Sorij coming through with the Glock 18, going in for that first kill. Glaive falls down, make that another one as he pushes, and Snappy falls down, even a third. Copenhagen Wolves, though, have got Hunden coming up from behind, and he goes in for Saw, makes it a 2-on-4 situation.
Yeah, but again, coming into this, you know, I feel like The odds are very obviously heavily in the favour of Copenhagen Wolves on betting sites like CSGO Lounge. So obviously it's like 80-20 right now, and I do feel like that's accurate. Arctic, you know, we've been praising them quite a lot, but recently, I mean, in actual recent online performance is not being too great, because obviously, you know, LAN, they're fairly consistent, but recently on online they've had some issues. So, you know, in terms of this league, they've only won one best of two and lost two best of twos. They haven't drawn any. So, you know, they won one against Enso, and then they lost one against Epiphany, and they lost one against Alagon. Like, these are teams they shouldn't be losing maps to. Or, sorry, matches to. Maybe maps to, but not matches. So, you know, coming into this, Arctic, they're at a serious disadvantage, I'd say. And Copenhagen Wolves, you know, we've been seeing them having phenomenal performance. And what's good to know is Copenhagen Wolves, they haven't actually dropped a map this whole event. Not one map. They won every single best of 2-0. And they're looking to carry that on, of course, though. Arctic are going to be kicking things off with a round. Again, for those wondering, this is going to be Copenhagen Wolves' map pick. They did win the 9th round, obviously, hence the CT side here. And second map will be Inferno. That's going to be Arctic's choice.
Bullets being fired here on B-Long. Percy will be trying to spot people out through that smoke, though. Backs off slowly. Copenhagen Wolves, like, and this is something about Copenhagen Wolves in particular, just on the CT side, that I've noticed in like the past few games. I didn't want to say this. I was going to say this on like this Tuesday, but I was going to wait to see if this is actually something they do on all maps. But they want that info on the CT side, try to get that first entry sometimes, just risking going a little bit further into the T side of the map, but then backing off, knowing that, okay, if there's no one here, then they're probably on another spot, right? So, basing their play off of that first information being very key to why I think they're so successful in particular rounds. But in this round, it's not going to pay off as clean, as Percy falls down on the box over on Plateau. Hunden with a flashbang is going to be supporting Glaive, it looks like, if he wants to push here. But countering that will be Arctic throwing over a nade to delay them from that one push. Eventually, Hunden is just lining this up, making sure that as soon as Arctic starts stepping heavily towards that Plateau, he'll be able to throw that flashbang out.
Oh, and Glaive.
Get a frags together with Glaive, and that works perfectly. The AK-47 in hands of him. If he just goes for a random spray here through the smoke, actually, they have no idea that he's here. He puts out another smoke, goes in for another headshot. Look at that. Seven falls down. What is this? Arctic decide to still push through that smoke. Sure, it's fading, obviously, but you hear that there's another nade coming up. You're not turning around. Glaive is allowed to get that kill, and it's a 2-on-4 situation right now. Obviously, heavily favored for Copenhagen Wolves looking at the time, right? Arctic, they have to go in for a save here. this is just straight up smart play coming up by Copenhagen Wolves. Look at how much just one flashbang. And something that you and I discuss a lot is, you know, don't go in for this straight up just pistol and armor rounds. You want to have at least some utility to work with. That just one flashbang changed the entirety of that round.
Yeah, really great play there up from Glaive, and of course he's going to be able to drop that AK there to Percy. Snappy, that's a bit of a risk with this buy. He's gone for the MAC-10. I really feel like even just a 5-7 alone would be a better idea. Allow Arctic to go for this force. It's very likely they're going to force. And then in the, you know, round after this, the preceding round, they go for the eco, and then Snappy will be able to use this MAC-10 to do a lot of damage, of course, against the non-armed players. But regardless, he should be able to swap it out for this M4 down and drop down. That would be a good decision, as obviously he has lost his teammate there. And Arctic, they're going to be still up to 5 men. Saw's heavily tagged right now, and Hunden, he's going to be the only man to hold off this A site. 3 players pushing towards it. Again, no bombs, so Arctic's still in a position where they're going to be able to commit to this B site. Even if they do lose players over towards A, and Hunden, he's got to step up massively here. We do have a rotation coming in from one of the players, but Hunden's going to be kicking things off there. First kill going in favor of Copenhagen Wolves. Snappy will do some work over towards drop down. Will be punished for it, though. And now it's going to be into a 3v2 as Hunden, he shuts down Twister. And right now, Saw again, 10 HP here, got to come in. And Percy, I think he spotted him out there from Plateau, and he'll be dropping down to the site. Finally, the split from drop down and from Plateau will come into play. Zori going to be opening things up, though. Percy will drop Hunden right back on the reply, and now Saw 1v2 with 10 HP. I don't see this happening, but who really knows? As Copenhagen Wolves, they go for the counter boost up towards long. This is a good strategy. They're going to be able to split towards the site, and Saw, he's going to have no idea. With 10 HP, it's going to be so difficult. But they're actually rotating a player over because they don't know this is B, maybe. They finally realise so, at least, and Saw, he's going to get wall banged out. Knew that would happen. Hunden, great game sense there, finishing him off, and that will be the round there to Copenhagen Wolves.
One thing that I got worried for a while, that Copenhagen Wolves was just going to throw that away because of the fact that Hunden was already jumping, but then realizing that SMF was inside a connector, starting to shoot like crazy through that door, actually, you know, caught, I don't know who it was it Saw? Saw's attention from Chicken Coop, and he just hid there for a while, knowing that, okay, they can come from both positions, right? So hiding myself from both of these angles are going to make, you know, it's probably going to give me a win if they don't have any nades left, but no. We just had that game since, just as you mentioned, by Hunden, going in for the straight-on split. I'm not sure if you spotted him out. Do you know?
No, but, I mean, you could see they were both just holding a crossfire, like that he's not peeking, the bomb's planted for Hunden there. The bomb was down for a position where he'd have to be around the site, and obviously Hunden and Snappy both cleared every spot, so he had to be in that position. At least to hold the bomb off, that is, but yeah. You know, just game sense comes into play there. And right now we're going to see Arctic charging over towards the B site here. Percy's going to be holding things off with his MP7. They don't check the spot. He picks up the first one, goes for the second, but maybe a bit preemptive as Orange. He's going to get the return frag. Glaive forced out back into the smoke, allowing Arctic to take control of the site. But the warbangs, the smoke shots from SMF are going to be completely devastating. Copenhagen Wolves, they will pick 3 rounds away from the Arctic side already. And again, this map is only... It's funny, an infograph was released today, actually, on that host. I saw it on Reddit, and it actually shows all the map percentages for, you know, whether it's CT or T-sided. And it's actually really surprising how equal most of the maps are. This map, specifically, is something like 55%.
Well, yeah, CT, I saw it. Was that on Twitter?
It might have been on Twitter as well. I saw it on Reddit. It was a really long one. And I read through the whole thing, and one of them said that, you know, CT side on this is like 52-53% maybe. So, heavily favouring no one really. Whereas, you know, you go into this map thinking it's a CT map, but even Inferno was only 57% apparently, which I don't think is correct. I think it must be a bit skewed by some, like, off games or something, because you don't tend to see that.
No, definitely not. But then. Yeah, I don't know. If they link like a source where they base their facts from, then that's...
No, they were proper facts.
Okay, well then, I guess...
I mean, they may have just been skewed, because obviously there's a few, like, 15 O's on T-side Inferno. That's going to make it T-side seem fairer.
Yeah. Well. Arctic here. And I gotta say, so far, like, their decisions, their quick decisions, something that we've been crediting Arctic for a lot has been just atrocious. It hasn't worked out at all. Like, obviously, I don't want to go harsh on them. I don't want to go hard on saying that, you know, they're super bad, blah, 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 blah. But these very small decisions that we've been crediting them for is not just there today. It looks like wasn't there this Tuesday either, where they lost against Epiphany Bolt. And I think
and
that's
Alagon on the same day.
Alagon, yeah. So just this is
the two weakest teams in this event, arguably, you know. Yet they still managed to beat Enzo, which just surprises me because Enzo are a decent team.
Definitely, definitely. Well, we'll see about this. Percy and the gang, Copenhagen Wolves, they will be playing a very defensive play, knowing that as soon as these nades drop down, they might be dropping down themselves, right? So as long as they've got a triple fire, I think this is a triple crossfire coming up by them. Saw goes in for that first kill, though, is allowed to get that without any reply coming up by Percy up from behind. Through that smoke, gets both of them, 7, and Saw goes down. They will be continuing a snappy with that AWP, just saves them. Just saves them on that site. Oh, the flick. Percy gets it on Tigerton. And Glaive on Twista will be getting Percy after going down into the grave, though. Doesn't really matter because looking at their money, they've started backing up pretty bad, right? You know, 7.4k on Glaive. Actually, does he have to buy anything? Yeah, okay. So, still 7.6 on Hunden there remaining.
Volti, I think we need to call the police preemptively because right now, I'm just predicting a complete murder. From Copenhagen Wolves. I'm just coming into this thinking that Arctic are going to get shredded alive. And I don't want to see that, obviously. I'd rather see a much fairer game. But Copenhagen Wolves, you know, we've seen their performance. As we said, they haven't lost a map, whereas Arctic, they've only won two. So, coming into this, I just feel like Copenhagen Wolves are just leagues above them.
Well, at least for now, it seems. I mean, Arctic, after all, you know, they won Nordic Masters. A lot of the teams were mixed, obviously, but during that time, and that, you know, that was probably their peak during this year, I'd say at least. But we'll see what comes up next here from them. Arctic are still going to go very, and Saw actually delivers two kills in middle. Glaven Hunden falls down, opens up that side for them, and it's still a 3-on-5. And I want to say that Copenhagen Wolves have got the positions to make this a little bit more fair for themselves. But SMF will be falling down. Snappy on the reply goes down eventually to Sagerton. So it's a back-to-back play here. Replies after replies coming up, so we will be going for that plant. 7. Oh, he failed the plant. No! It might be so key, but 7 in the end saves them as Percy goes in for that very... It's still a very defensive peak, but is spotted out by him and goes down. Arctic's last member being... I think that was 7. So, 5-2. And economically, Copenhagen Wolves will be downed to pretty much no money at all after this round. They lose it, so Arctic can really play off of this. Once again, that is only one round for them, right? So they might be reset when it comes to the bonus here either way. So it's really do or die for both of the teams.
Definitely so, and of course, Sagerton being down on this Tech 9 may be a bit of an issue for Arctic despite, you know, winning the previous round, you can see. So going for this AWP over the double AK, it seems at the moment, and right now, Arctic is just going to be making slow progress over towards A, but SMF, nice casual boost over there. We'll pick up the first one. Seven's going to get the reply, so we're back into a 4-on-4. This still favours Arctic. They're going to only use a Tech 9 player now, so they're still on the four rifles, and Copenhagen Wolves, they've got less players to spit throughout the map. They have to go for a 2-2 setup, you can see, over towards the site. And Percy, he's going to be caught out here, it seems. Saw, actually, going to be going for the smoke shot. We'll land it onto Glaive there. Good kill on towards the B site. Percy's going to be alone now, but Arctic, this is interesting. Copenhagen Wolves haven't rotated their player over, and instead Arctic are going for the fake over towards B and actually committing to A site where Copenhagen Wolves had two of their players at. So this could be a really risky play, and I'm not sure if it will pay off too well. Hunden hits his first shots over towards his position. It should be okay for them. Snappy though, going to be picking up that first onto Zori, so it's already equalising back into a 3-on-3 as Arctic, they make their debut onto the site here. Sort going to finish off Hunden, but Snappy, he's snapping angles and snapping necks as well. Second kill coming out from him, and Percy's going to finish the things off. And Copenhagen Wolves 6-2. Arctic really misplay going back to the A site there. And Copenhagen Wolves, you know, absolutely great game sense not rotating a player over from the A site.
And this is exactly what I talked about before that round even started, is that, okay, Arctic, they're going to be down to the worst money situation probably in this first half right now because of the fact that they lost that round. Copenhagen Wolves could potentially be so if Arctic won as well, but in this scenario, Copenhagen Wolves clearly has the best advantage possible. One thing that we see here is one flash and a smoke from Saw, so if that's utilized in the best possible way for the team, then that's gonna work its way out just fine to at least get a couple of frags here and there. But I am assuming that Copenhagen Wolves have got this under control. X7 will be going in for a first kill, make that a second as he pushes through. Drop Percy in a good spot and has the patience to stay there, not going in for a peek, not a reply or anything, knowing that, okay, they're going to get up here either way. Right, so Snappy with that AWP will be getting information. And once again, very key reason to why they win rounds here is that, okay, they're very aggressive, they risk a lot, but as soon as it starts working for them, they get those rounds. So Hunnen here with a backup play, knowing that, okay, he will be backing off over to Connector, will go in for that kill as well. Saw falls down, and 7-2 is a result of that. But again, Copenhagen Wolves, thanks to the fact that they can be very offensive and still survive, you know, backing off and go into their defensive positions afterwards, is a key thing that I think leads them into a lot of winning rounds here against Arctic. Arctic, what I'd rather see from them here is, you know, play a little bit more defensive at the very beginning of rounds, which they do. They do have that neutral play, but they don't use any crossfire positions. They don't expect Copenhagen Wolves to come a lot of the time, giving Copenhagen Wolves that first kill, giving them that first entry, allowing Arctic to, you know, eventually equalize. But it doesn't matter because Copenhagen Wolves, they've already got that information. So 7-2 is what we're looking at, and continuing into this, they will be executing to the A site.
But here we go, Hunden's going to be challenging this first push of Arctic right now, but they will be back on off. Flash goes in, and actually going to be taking the bomb back towards the B site here. So, oh, this is good though, because Copenhagen Wolves have rotated 5 of their players over. It's going to be a completely clear site for Arctic. They'll be able to push all their players onto B if they hurry up with this one. Glaive is going to be the first to come back in. They've realized they made a huge mistake here, and SMF also going to join it. It's safe to say they will be rotating almost all of their players over, of course, expecting this late push. But what have Arctic done? They've wasted time. They've allowed Copenhagen Wolves to move back into the usual position here, and essentially going towards this B site is no different from going towards it at the beginning of a round. Same setups coming out from Copenhagen Wolves. Nothing has changed, aside from Arctic have lost a minute of their time with no map control.
And this is where Copenhagen Wolves, all they really are going to be doing, they're going to have that standard setup. Obviously, something we talked about earlier is that, okay, they were really offensive, but here they aren't. They're actually basing their play off of just having crossfire positions. A lot of the time, just replies here and there. Saw, oh my god, what a headshot. Snappy falls down. Hunden's left alone in a 1-on-3. Goes in for a first frag. Seven falls down. This could be potential, since he has that flashbang, picks up another one. Potentially faking into, actually, it's going to go straight into the schmeg of this. Knowing that that bomb is planted towards Long, he'll probably figure that, okay, they should be playing towards Long as well, right? So, what he's really doing here is just waiting for them to go in for that peek. Not sure if he's going to fake the fuse or anything. Looking for the players. We'll spot one of them out. But still, that timer is ticking. Flashbang. Not going to be enough. If he had a smoke, that could be potential blocking off Long eventually, but then again, you'd never be sure of drop, right? So, a lot of the times here, you just, you know, the B site is very easy to crossfire on, and there's a lot of positions, and, you know, what is it that we say, nooks and crannies, that you can, you know, you need to check as a CT before you go in for that straight-up defuse, because it's not going to work the first time. Obviously, Arctic, they have one behind that box. It's going to be very obvious. He tried to go in for that kill, didn't really work it out. Eventually thought that someone was towards chicken coop, could be drop, eventually come up from your back, from connector, you know, jumping down drop, all those things are potential here. So, he played that well, I want to say, knowing that he had no chance. Hunden will be backing off. Twista goes down there. The early beginning of rounds, again, pushing, knowing that they have that information now.
But already with this early advantage in Arctic, they're still going to be pushing out onto this B site. It could be a bit difficult, but Sagaton's going to start making it easier. First kill coming up from him. SMF, he gets caught out, but actually going to be able to regain his position here. Still, information has been gathered by Arctic, and he's down to 21 HP in the process, so this isn't good for him. Flash goes in. Zori will peek with it. Sagaton going to burn him alive, though, as Arctic, they make their way onto the site, and it's a very good push so far. Hunden's right there to hold things off, but not for long, as he gets dropped by 7, and it's all going to be on Snappy here. 1v3. In the same position as Hunden last round, and this is going to be a difficult one to even attempt to come back into the site. I think a save may be in order right now.
And once again, that B site, a lot of nooks and crannies that we talked about earlier, it's just straight out back off. You're not going to get any more kills here. Arctic aren't going to allow you. They know that that money situation is so key to having, and that's something that we credit them for, even when they lost against Epiphany Bowl, is that they have that money play, sometimes losing it a little bit, but overall has a good money play in comparison to other semi-professional teams, or, yeah, professional. Arctic are actually professionals here, so, we'll see if they Because they won't be risking anything, right? They have the sense of how they want to play against Copenhagen Wolves, which is smart. Now, the A1S here on Snappy, blessed with some body armor, obviously, together with that smoke and flashbang. I'm assuming he's just going to play a very backup role for the rest of the players. But they do have the utility here to work with. Obviously, we like saying that, okay, if you don't invest anything into a straight-up pistol round, it doesn't really. But since you have that one very heavy rifle here and utilities, it doesn't really matter whether you invest more into it or not because it's already there. So, 5-on-5 still in the game. Looks like a straight-up round for Arctic if they just play this right. Sari will be going in for the first kill. Hunden falls down. Small peeks here and there just to gather info. Snappy is going to thrive off of that information, though, and it works out just fine for him to get that first kill. Sireton will be going down due to that matter of fact being. Now they push up towards Long, and this actually might be paying off cleaner than I think. Percy is in a very close spot. Backs off with the AK-47, drops it over to another mate, and Percy is still in that corner.
They don't know.
They have absolutely no
That's
idea.
That's so clever, giving the gun to his teammate, so he's in a great position. He'll be able to peek out and get those kills. They won't check it, but... Oh, 7, he's got a pre-fire it anyway. Who cares? He knows exactly what he's doing. 3v4 now, and Arctic have a thorough advantage, but Copenhagen Wolves, they still have two rifles, but again, these are both towards a B site in Arctic. They're going to be heading over towards A. So Glaive's got to do all the work with just a USP Vaulty. I don't know about you, but I don't see this one happening for Copenhagen Wolves.
It would take more than just a miracle, I'd say, but we'll see about this. Glaive is going to be backing off. He's going to give information that, okay, there's one up towards middle. He was backing off towards the site, so one is at least on the site. They know that he's there. He's shooting like crazy, so he's still looking for him. Eventually gets that kill. Takes his time, though, but 20 seconds remaining. Na'Vi raiding their computers today again, but it works this time. 4-on-1 situation, and SMF deciding to back off with that AK-47, which I highly would advise anyone to do, really. It's just, you know that this is pretty much more than impossible, so... And do we see that spot again today?
Ooh, we do indeed. I like this one.
Yeah, I like this one
too. Good save spot.
But wasn't it Arctic who used it last time?
Yeah, probably.
So... I think Copenhagen Wolves, they saw the stream, right? They knew instantly that they were going to use this in the future. Arctic are looking, but they're not going to find too much. Could be a kill here, but still dotable.
No, there's only 2 seconds. There's only 2 seconds post round on this config, so it's not going to happen.
7-5, and Arctic are trying to take this back. I mean, 3 rounds in a row here. Copenhagen Wolves, obviously, with that 3-round loss bonus, are going to be allowed to buy here. But with only one death kit, I highly suggest that you just play safe this time, not allowing them to get into the site in the first play, or first place, because the retake situation is going to get even more stressed out if you don't have those death kits. Obviously, low utility as well, so...
But my words are really coming back to haunt me. You know what I said a few rounds ago, it'd be a slaughter. Yeah. It's now 7-5. I said this at 7-2. So Arctic, they're on the way to a great comeback. And they're not out of the game, of course. It's early on, still in the first half. So they're definitely not out of the count. And they will be working their way to drop down, it seems. Plenty of nades going in. And they will finally be dropping after this Molotov just dissipates that. And Arctic's just waiting for some aggression right now from the CTs. But you can see Copenhagen Wolves not going to really be giving them anything. Snappy just holding the outside so they can't drop into connector. The rest of the players just over towards B right now. And SMF and Snappy are going to be the main two men to hold this off if they do go into drop down. But Arctic being as indecisive as ever and backing off. Obviously just playing for picks down there, forcing some CTs to move out of a close position or try and go for a peek and then get shut down, and then trying to get that pick. That's a good way to get a pick, but the utility will slightly lack if they continue to do it every round without anyone falling for it. And it seems like Arctic are going to be going towards this A site now, so this is where the battle comes in. And Snappy, where's he playing? Oh, he's down towards lower mid, but they're not going to be pushing out there all out long. And they still do need to clear this position, despite Snappy not being anywhere in it. And Hunden, look at him. This is going to be great from him. He's got a great one. All he's got to worry about is his lower mid right now, and he is going to be holding it. Sagaton gets shut down. Saw also in position. Hunden's going to pick up both kills. Sees the third. Takes him down. Zori will fall, and now it's going to be Arctic with 10 seconds left. No access to the bomb and two players to try and come back from this round, but it doesn't look like it's meant to be. Glaive will finish things off with the final nail in the coffin. Snappy comes in from behind.
We got that right this time.
Yeah, the head of the nail in the head of the coffin.
Yeah, the head of the head kale nail. I don't know what. Yeah, at the end of the day here, Copenhagen Wolves, they... I don't know what happened with Arctic's communication there, because Suri was literally standing just beneath... was that Hunden on the position?
Yeah.
On the boost? Yeah. He was literally standing beneath him for, I don't know how long, like 5 seconds, 4 seconds, so... With that being said, Arctic, the communication-wise, it doesn't look like it's working out perfectly fine for them. It works out for 5 rounds, though, but... Looks like Copenhagen Wolves still has the upper hand when it comes to just communicating quickly and turning over to sides here and there. Knowledge-wise, I feel, you know, experience-wise, Arctic are probably an advantage of this one, but Copenhagen Wolves are, very fair to say, at this very point in time, a stronger team individually.
I definitely agree with that. But... Either way, we will see a bit of bomb towards the top mid once again. Great pick there by Sakaton. Nice boost to take advantage of Percy there, and that's going to be the first pick for Arctic as we go into this round. And counter boost coming out from Copenhagen Wolves. This could be fun. Glaive's going to be put up, and the flash will go in. That's a great flash. Just bounces off and pops right in their face, but he won't be going for the peak with that smoke coming out instead, just to hold him off. And right now, the rest of Arctic, they're heading over towards A, bomb in hand as well. And you can see Copenhagen Wolves are not ready for this one. Three players over towards B in the 4v5, of course, they're going for the 3-1 split instead, and now Glaive is going to be picking things up here for Copenhagen Wolves, picking up the first kill with that, and Hunden takes a second, but 7, damage a lot, will drop Snappy, and that's all that matters. 3v3, but caught from behind. Hunden, he's playing like a madman on this site. Two players down already, and now Arctic will be allowed to get this bomb plant. So Copenhagen Wolves, 3v2, got to come back in. AWP is going to be on Zori, so they've got to watch out for that one if they're not aware of this, because they haven't actually seen it yet this round. They still don't know if he has it. It could be a real issue, and Hunden's going to safe peek it, so going well for him already, and Copenhagen Wolves attempting to come back into this round, but sorry, again, he wants to challenge this. Twister will come into a gunfight, going to lose it, it's all going to be on Zori, 1v3 here, and they're just going to run back into the site. He picks up the first one, going for the re-peek, but still not punished, and finally Hunden, he's going to shut things down there for Arctic, and Copenhagen Wolves will finally get another round on the board, 9-5.
And they do have the time, but still that death kit... Could have changed everything. Yeah, Hunden actually had one, so it doesn't really matter here. Unless he picked that up on the way down. But still, 9-5. And Arctic are blessed to have the amount of money that they have here. But I wouldn't say a full buy is... Okay, actually it is, because it's the last round. What am I thinking with here? I thought it was a almost last round. Hunden goes in for 2 kills right there. Should be easy for him. Shouldn't be a problem. Wasn't too heavy artillery, as we said. Tuesday was artillery cannons and stuff, right? Wasn't any of the likes of that. Saw 7 left alone. 2-on-4 situation. I don't see this one coming through from Arctic. I don't know about you, but this is okay. They're gonna push together towards B as soon as they spot Spur Percy out. Even if Saw gets this kill, they're gonna have that very key information. Yeah, he's not even gonna get that.
Bomb
so,
down
bomb
as
is
well.
Dropped.
Oh, they're all over for 7, really. Nothing he can do. This will be a 10-5 half for Copenhagen Wolves.
Oh, well.
Pretty simple shutdown, though. Arctic actually picked up more rounds than I suppose they would coming into this, but again, you know, 5-10 half really isn't good enough on Cobble.
Yeah, I know. Judging by the stats that we were talking about earlier, it definitely isn't. Should be more 9-6 in my, like, just one round is actually a big thing here, I want to say. But, Arctic, still, they get the amount of rounds that they need to maybe shine off of this. We'll see about this first pistol round and then judge by how quick things go, right? If Copenhagen Wolves wins this one, then might be easier for them. Or it is going to be easier for them to win this, but anyway, anyhow, SMF and Hunden, they've got the utility, and I highly doubt that SMF should be standing in this position, advisedly, you know, telling him to back off pretty much just because of the fact that it's so risky, but they've got two players backing each other up. Jesus, I'm losing so many words today.
You're not alone, man, you're not alone.
Is it 421, right, so... Who...
Just recovering from yesterday, are you? But either way here, seems like Copenhagen Wolves have set their sights on the B site. Although the bomb still hasn't made its way committed towards it, of course, and we will see a bit of aggression coming up towards B again, a bit of a fake over towards A from one player. That's going to be Glaive there with the armor and now the smokes, and plenty of them will come out onto the B site here. SMF leading the charge, going to be dropping saw here, a bit of a return fire, but SMF, he's going to be securing two in the bag, and Copenhagen Wolves are going to be at a great chance here to pick up this round. Zori, he's going to have something to say about that though, comes in from drop down and shuts down SMF once again. Twister has some return fire onto Hunden, but it's not going to kill him, just put him down to very low HP, and Snappy and Hunden, they should be clearing this one up. There we go, double kill from Hunden there, and we will see 11 rounds go to Copenhagen, so great start here.
Yeah, this is why I don't understand how Arctic in the first place doesn't even, like, really what they should be doing here is that, okay, they're coming for a connector, they should know that there is probably going to be someone in drop holding that off from window and potentially from the back, and then one obviously close to Dwayne or closer to Stone or whatever you want to, Rock, whatever you want to call that, just holding that off towards connector. But instead, they try to push together to get that information. They don't even pre-peek any positions or anything. They try to spot the first man out. And it doesn't work like that at all when it comes to meeting, especially Copenhagen Wolves in this scenario. And Twista, unluckily, holds that nade. Snappy wasn't stepping or anything either way, so he easily had that knife if he wanted to. Easily. But MAC-10 is going to give him enough to just thrive off of that. $100 in comparison isn't too much either way. But getting into the A site, it's going to be all clean. Copenhagen Wolves, they can pretty much just use their utilities to force Arctic to lose this round. It's like that 5-7 might make a difference, you know, pick up a weapon on Snappy, but that's only a MAC-10 either way. So in the next round, Copenhagen Wolves are going to get ready for that. And even if it would make any sense in this round for them to pick, you know, try and go in for it, they're hearing AKs here and there, so it wouldn't make sense to me, right?
And they really want these frags. Copenhagen Wolves not letting anything go out of this, and Snappy will go huge. Is that an ace? Yeah, that is.
Just so beautiful. 7.4k in the third round of the half. It just shouldn't be that way. It just shouldn't be that way. Arctic. I love Arctic. You know, from the bottom of my heart, I like that team. I like Copenhagen Wolves as well, but I just don't see the same Arctic I saw a couple of months ago playing Nordic Masters. I don't see the same that I saw just a couple of weeks ago, actually. I think exactly 1 month ago when they played online as well, when they were boot camping. I think you and I casted that. Or maybe we didn't.
Yeah,
I'm not too sure.
We did.
Maybe that was a game show, maybe.
I think it was game show.
Yeah. Anyways, they played super well. They played that absolutely magnificently. But from somewhere, this very sloppy play, careless play has come in to hamper them. I don't know, maybe it's just a period, you know, sometimes teams has these periods like NIP not winning a single thing in a single big tournament in 18 months.
Yeah, that's not a period, that's just a complete failure. It's when it's a couple of weeks is a period. 18 months, yeah. That's not a period, man. That's just
that's 18 months.
Yeah, that's 18 months. But Budget NC having some serious problems here. They will be finally going for this buy. AWP up on Zori. One kit across the whole board. So, issues here. And, of course, not a lot of utility on Zori, but the rest of them are going to be fully equipped, pretty much. A couple of decoys in the mix for some fun little fake flashes. But either way, Copenhagen Wolves is going to be heading up towards A long, and this is where the challenge will come out. I think that's Zori over there with the AWP, and it will be so. No, sorry, Twister, actually. Oh, look at his position, though. This is interesting. He's jumping over the smoke. Oh, great shot by Snappy. He's going to spot him out there and take him down. Bit of team damage coming out as well. As we do see a kill come out from Zori with the AWP. But right now, Arctic got to hold this off as Copenhagen Wolves look like they want to commit to this A site right now. They run right past him. Glaive turns around, though. Sakaton's going to fall. And now Arctic already have to come in for the retake as the double mollies head out everywhere. And Copenhagen Wolves are going to have this site for free. No contestant from Arctic right now, and the bomb will be going down on the site, so that's going to be the money locked in for next round at a minimum. And Arctic, they've got a lot on their shoulders and a lot of pressure here, obviously, with this 13-5 scoreline.
We'll see here still, but there's not much to say, really. I mean, Copenhagen Wolves just getting into that site now. Arctic forced to back offshore. They get that first kill on Percy. It doesn't really matter because Copenhagen Wolves, and I think this is particularly just Copenhagen Wolves, that on the T side, they play this similarly to what they did on the CT side, where they really try to thrive off of their information. But Instead, on that T side, they have not a bait, but a first player who tries to go in for the very first entries. If he dies, they instantly reply him, and if he saw even more people backing off, they just know that, okay, there's more people towards this area. We can just smoke that off, nade that off, you know, use our every Molotov and everything just to get into that site as soon as possible. And as soon as they're on that site, you know, Arctic has already taken their time to stand on the outline of that site. Copenhagen Wolves, they can pretty much just crossfire every position that they can come through. And especially on Cobble, where you're coming from Connector, it's such a squishy place to push through. If you're not coming from Middle or A-Long, I'd say A-Long is even squishier than sometimes Connector can be. So, depending on what smokes and utilities, depending on what utilities, obviously, Copenhagen Wolves uses here, it's still in favor of them. Doesn't ever go out of hand for them here. 14-5, and Arctic forced down to actually not. I mean, looking at what they got, this is only weapons. This is all individual skill, pretty much raw skill, in you know, in touch with dodging nades from Copenhagen Wolves here. Because looking at what they got, it's quite an amount. Glaive coming through, and Seven will be flashed out just as Glaive pushes through, goes in for another one. That's gonna be easy for him. Sagerton goes down as well, and out on the site, we got Glaive going in for another one. Softball down, make that a fourth almost. Twista, though, will be replying instantly. Glaive goes down, and Percy on Twista right there makes sure that not allowed to get more. Saree, AWP, risks out on two no-scopes. Nappy with that off, goes in for the kill in the end, 15-5. Looking very dire for Arctic right here.
I think dire is an understatement, to be honest. To the point where they're getting an auto sniper on Zori, you know, that says itself, really. But either way, 15-5, and yeah, I will say this was a murder, and now I stand by my choice. As soon as I say Arctic are coming back, they lose the next 10 rounds. So, right now, Copenhagen Wolves tearing apart the finish lineup here. Second best finish team around.
Yeah.
Percy, though, going to be kicking things off with a kill onto Saw here. Copenhagen Wolves up a man once again, and Arctic, again, this is the issue. They're not trading, really. They're losing these early players, and this is a huge deficit, leaving them in a huge deficit right now. So, you know, being down men early on in rounds never helps. And, you know, Copenhagen Wolves have a minute 10 on the clock to do really anything they want with this map, and they're not even going to wait down the time. They're just going to pull full push onto the site here. Percy going to open things up, and Zori, he gets aggressive. Mollies are going in. They're a bit of a fail from Glaive. The Copenhagen Wolves, like, four players up towards Platt. They're going to be committing to this. There's no question about it. SMF going to be taking out Seven. Another rotation's coming in from Twister and Sagerton. He tries to hold things off, but I think these are just consolidation frags right now, as Copenhagen Wolves are just looking to close this out in due time.
And they just want to make sure that they can win this. I think that's the thing here. And look at that, Glaive. He dies. Sure, they get that information. Well, what is going on, Twista? What are you doing? What are you doing? SMF went down. That bomb is going to get dropped. He's forced out. No, okay, look at that. Snappy goes in for the kill. I didn't even see it from Connector. I didn't see ever that he'd go by that move. But hey, AK-47 on Sagerton. He hears that plant, and this is just going to force him into going for the kill. And he makes that happen, actually. Hunton falls down and wins the round. So luckily for Arctic, they will still have another chance. But I still say that this is just consolidation rounds, if anything. I stick by my word.
A 2v5.
It's weird. It doesn't happen all the time. Arctic, maybe they're back, maybe they're not, but I'd still say that even if they do step this up, there's going to be one or two rounds where they're going to be having their flaws, and Copenhagen Wolves are going to take it home by then easily.
Yeah.
Even if Arctic steps this up,
they'll eventually exploit them, you know, regardless of you know, how many rounds Arctic can get. At this kind of level, you see that, I don't like to talk about this a lot because it's quite controversial, but the thing is, at the highest level of CS, so tier 1 teams, you know, you can look at a 15-6 scoreline and go, okay, it's possible to come back. At these level of teams, there are so many mistakes that are being made, even small ones that have such big impacts, you go 15-6 is GG. Like, you can just call it, you know, it's over for Arctic in this first map. But at top level play, you go, okay, they know how to handle themselves in those situations. And that's why you shouldn't ever call GG in the very top level of play. But right now, I just think for Arctic, yeah, what you said, you know, they're a good team. They're going to be able to get a few rounds, maybe. But eventually, Copenhagen Wolves will just exploit them and tear them out of the server. You know, it's just a sense of when this is going to happen, not if this is going to happen.
It's really just common sense. I mean, looking at the teams we're watching, I mean, it's not like It's not like these guys played at the major, right? It's as easy as that. If you look at the major, sure, NIP, or not NIP, but you know, NIP being one of the teams. I like comparing a lot of things with NIP, even though I'm not a big fan of them. But like they're very good with getting a lot of rounds in a row. Like we saw that. I think that was on Masters Malmo. We saw the same thing. Hunden
well,
goes
they
after
won
that first
it, so clearly.
Yeah, they won it. So yeah, clearly. Oh, I just copied what you just said without thinking that I copied it.
Yeah, dude, nice English. Either way, that's going to be the wrap. As we're just talking about DreamHack Malmo, Snappy and SMF finishing off for Copenhagen Wolves. But again, 16-6, not really much to go into on analysis there. Copenhagen Wolves really tearing apart the opposition and a great 1-0 lead to start off this best of two here. But of course, we're not done for the night. We do have one more map coming up, and this is obviously going to be the second one in the series to see if Arctic can try and come back for retribution, or if Copenhagen Wolves are going to go flawless with yet another map won in this event.